Hello designers and welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I will show you how to create an isometric cardboard box and how to position the flaps at offset angles whilst keeping the correct perspective. Let's jump right in. So one of my subscribers asked me how I would go about creating a cardboard box with the lid partially open and they are finding it hard to draw offset shapes. So if you think of the grid, I'll just activate the grid. This shape is kind of is within the kind of parameters, these grid squares here. This kind of is kind of following that, and this is kind of like an offset shape. It's not following those lines at all. So they were finding it quite confusing how to get the correct perspective or the correct angle or length it should be when they were trying to play around with it. Maybe with this tool, just kind of playing around with it like that, you can see, oh look, you wouldn't know exactly how long or short it should be going around, and then what if you wanted it that side, how would you do that? So that's what we're going to look at today. I'm going to show you a technique I use, and I'm not sure it's perfect, but it does seem to work for me, and if you have a better idea, I'd love to know what you are doing. So before we do any of that, let me just deactivate the grid, and I'll show you a few of my settings. Just hide that box there. So I have snapping turned on. This is what I have ticked. And document setup. And I have this isometric panel activated as well. How do you get that? Well, you go to View, Studio, Isometric, click on that, and this panel will appear. It'll appear here or in one of these kind of tabs here. You can see it. Let's just click on top for now and edit in plane. And to activate the grid, shortcut, command, single quotation mark. You can see it down there in the bottom left-hand corner. So I'm just going to quickly draw out a kind of cube shape. If you want to know how to do that, you can check out some of my other videos. Very easy to follow tutorial. So anyway, I'm just going to power through and make the initial cube shape. But I will say this when I'm making it. I'm snapping to the center here. I'm going to make it cover four of these kind of big squares. Because we're going to use this for kind of measuring what we're going to do with the lid. Okay, so click in the center, command and shift to drag out to keep the proportions. We'll make this black in the colors tab. And we'll press escape. And now we'll press front so we can draw that side. Just click on shift and we'll choose a color. I make this slightly light on that side. And I'll press V for the move tool, command J to duplicate that, and I'll just flip it around, flip horizontally. I'll just drag it out and snap it into place there, and I'll choose a darker color for that one. Okay, so we have our basic cube shape. Let's imagine this is the cardboard box, and this is inside the cardboard box. Let's make our first lid. So I'll just activate the grid again. What we're going to do, we're going to select this shape here and we're going to press Command J to duplicate that. Now, I'm just going to bring this up to the top layer here. And what we're going to do is drag the handle so it's halfway down. It's exactly one of those small blocks across. So we have kind of like half of that big shape we started off with. And what we're going to do is click on Shift, keep your finger on Shift and drag outwards like so until it clicks into place here. And we're going to change the color of that to something light. So we have our first flap. Let's duplicate that so we can make it go all around the box. Click on that again. I'll press Command J and that's duplicated it. And again, shift, drag, snap to place, select both of them. And now press Command J. That's duplicated them. And just go up to the transform tools, flip horizontal. We have an open box now. This is our open box. I'll probably make that a little bit darker. There we go, like that. So the next step is to make a guide. So before I do that, I'm just going to hide this shape here. And we're going to be concentrating on this flap. So head on over and click on the ellipse tool. And activate your grid again. And just make sure that front is selected. So you're on the front plane. Okay, press escape so nothing's selected. And we're just going to go in and we're going to click and drag Command and Shift to keep the perspective. We'll drag it out until it comes out four big blocks like that. I'm going to just change the color so it's a little bit easier to see and bring down the opacity. Okay, so this is our guide. This is going to help us figure out how we're going to play around with this. So the first thing I'm going to do with this is click on Convert to Curves. And I'm going to click on A for the node tool, which is up here. And then I want to select both of these nodes here. So I'm going to click and hold Alt. And then I'm going to click and drag out. And now I can just draw around whichever nodes I want. Okay, with both selected, I can simply click and drag. And if I follow this line, it kind of gives me a guide into how tall it should be, the length of it. So if you look here, it's still one block thick. And if I go across, it gets to this section. It's still one block thick. And just what I mean by block is it's one of these deep gray line here. And I'll just drag it down and you can kind of see how it's how it works. So if I just leave this around, let's leave it around here. Okay, so that's our first one complete. So if I want to play around with this one here, I would simply click and drag this across until it snaps into place on this corner. And I will click on that, convert to curves, do the same again, click A, hold down Alt, click and drag around those nodes. And we can use this again. And I'll just drag that behind the black square there. And I'll make it slightly darker because it will be kind of in the shade there. Let's just get rid of that guide for now. Yeah, let's make that a little bit darker. Maybe something like that. So you can see it's starting to shape up. Let's do the same with these sides, but we're going to have to create another guide because it's kind of on a different perspective. So let's activate the grid again. What we're going to do is we're going to press side now. Side. I'm going to go up and press escape, and we're just going to draw again over our four big squares like that until it snaps into place again. Change the color. Let's make it a kind of blue one this time. And I'm going to select the shape, and it's just the same again. So convert to curves, A, Alt, click, drag, and we're going to follow these lines. See, wherever I drag it, it kind of looks like it kind of should do. If you feel like it's getting too long, maybe just do it like that and then around. But you can see it's really kind of working here. So I'm going to make this one go inwards like so, just like our first image that I showed you. And again, I'll press V, the move tool, and just drag it down. It snaps into that corner. And let's bring that layer back. And it's the same again. Okay, I'll delete that. And we'll have a look at it, see what it looks like. See, that looks pretty good to me. And it doesn't seem like the flaps are too long. And it seems like the perspective is good. And I didn't have to use the pen tool or anything. I just dragged a few nodes around. And that's pretty much how I make the cardboard boxes. I've gone ahead and chosen colors that match the cardboard box a little bit better. And I've filled in inside the box like that. If you want to see how I did it, I will show you now. So we've got this one here. I'll just copy this shape, Command J, and keep my finger on Shift and drag it up and snap it to that side. I should probably turn on the grid. Okay, and for this one, we're going to want to grab the fill tool and just click and drag upwards like that. And we'll just drag that side down. And for this side, we're going to choose a kind of darker color. I'll just grab a color from the side there and a lighter color for the top. I'll just choose something like that for now. Make it a little bit darker there and darker still down there. So we'll leave it at that for now. And the next thing we're going to want to do is press P for the pen tool, which is here. Just click in the corner up there, go to somewhere in the middle. This will be the shadow of the box. So maybe something like that. And the next thing we're going to do is press V for the move tool. We're going to copy this, Command J, And I'm going to drag the bottom layer that we produced and just drag it across. And we're going to do the same here. So I'm just going to drag that up. Actually, I'll drag down as the darker color is down there. And somewhere like that. And we'll just choose an appropriate color now. And I think that kind of works. Maybe a bit more color here. Somewhere like that. And a little bit darker here. And you can see it's kind of going over here. We don't want that. So I'm going to select all of these shapes that we've just created. So all these three. And I'm just going to throw it into the black layer before. So drag it down underneath the black layer. And then to the right. And it will clip inside of there. Let go. And we have our box complete. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you found that tutorial useful. If you did, click subscribe and hit like if you want to see my future videos. Also, leave a comment in the comment section below and let me know what you think, if you have any questions, etc. All right, see you on the next one.